How's it going, you guys? I'm Kidan and welcome back to another Cyberpunk Tips and Guides tutorial, and in this video I'll be showing you guys how to get unlimited crafting components. Now, crafting plays a big part in this game, and having unlimited crafting components really helps and allows you to craft pretty much everything and upgrade everything to the max level. And also do keep in mind that this is a beginner guide, means everyone that just started playing the game, this video is for you guys. And now if you guys take a look at my crafting components, I pretty much have unlimited, but normally it is very difficult to have a lot of crafting components in the game. But by using this exploit, I'm gonna show you guys how to pretty much get unlimited crafting components. And you guys can do this pretty early in the game as well, but to get unlimited crafting components, you will need a lot of money and reach level 50 to have all the perks unlocked to craft anything in the game. So be sure to check out my previous video where I've shown you guys how to get to level 50 in no time, and also how to make unlimited money before you get started with this, because those steps are required if you want to get unlimited crafting components. Now if you guys find this guide helpful at any point, leaving a like would really mean a lot. Now I want to quickly go back in an early point in the game to show you guys how to get the component first. Now if you guys take a look at here, I pretty much have no components at the moment. Pretty much nothing. So what you guys need to do is head over to the map. So when you guys open up the map, head over to this location on Haywood, and you guys will see this junk shop right next to where I'm currently at. And I highly recommend going to this one because it has a certain item that we need to buy. All right, so as soon as you guys get here, you'll see this musical store called Time Machine. So what you guys need to do is go inside. All right, so once you guys get inside the store, by the way, the store looks pretty awesome. I recommend you guys look around. So what you guys need to do is go to the store vendor, and you will find this two legendary Johnny Silverhand records called Never Fade Away and Samurai Blastering Love, and they each cost 600 eddies. So now what you guys need to do is buy both of them, and they will give you guys crafting components. Now let me quickly show you guys that currently I don't have any crafting components, pretty much nothing, but now I'm gonna go ahead and buy these two records, and that will give me few crafting components for each. All right, now let's go over to our book pack, and as you guys can see, I got few components for each of those crafting components after buying those two records. So after you guys have few components for each of those crafting components, what you guys need to do is to pretty much find a drop box, and there is also a drop box right near the store. Alright, so once you guys get to the drop box, what you guys need to do is go over to all items, and you will see all those components. Then what you guys need to do is sell each component. And what I mean by that is go ahead and sell one component for each. Alright, so once you guys have done that, the next step is to activate the duplication glitch. So if you guys are on PlayStation, it's Option and Triangle, and if you're on Xbox, it's Start and Y, and if you're on PC, it's Escape key and E, I believe. I'm not sure. I'm not entirely sure about PC, so if anyone knows, be sure to let everybody know in the comment section below. And so you guys need to press those two buttons at the same time to activate that glitch. And now do keep in mind that it's gonna take a couple of tries to get it right. So as soon as you guys see something like this, a transparent background, meaning it worked. And as soon as it worked, what you guys can do is buy the same item as much as you like. I mean, there is no limit. You guys can go all day if you like. But I highly recommend for you guys to see my money guide before doing this and get tons of money, because getting all those components will cost you a lot. So I highly recommend for you guys to have a lot of money before doing this. And also having a lot of money will save you a lot of time and make this process much faster. Now I'm gonna show you guys a fastest way to do this. So once you guys have a lot of money, what you guys need to do is sell a bunch of these components at once. And pretty much do the same thing for all the other components as well. And that way, instead of keep on pressing the button, you can get so much in very little time. Now as you guys can see, I've spent a lot of money buying all those components, which means now the vendor machine has more money and you will be able to sell more, which means the more you sell, the more you get to buy. Alright, now as you guys can see, I pretty much sold a lot of them at once, which pretty much means that I'll be able to buy back same amount at once, and you guys can get over thousands of components within a minute, and I'll show you guys just how. And also do keep in mind that the money you guys will spend in the vendor, you will be able to get it back, and I'll show you guys how to do it at the end. Now the reason I spent so much money because I was able to sell a lot of components, because that's what you guys need to do. Spend a lot of money, then you can sell a lot of components. So once you sell like a lot of components, you'll be able to buy back all those components at once. And what I mean by that, for example, if you sell 5,000 of one of those components, and you'll be able to buy 5,000 back at one press. So if you guys do that multiple times, you know, it will get so much, you get so much components in no time. And that's pretty much all you guys need to do. Just repeat the same process as much as you like until you guys feel like you have enough. And now I'm gonna show you guys how to get back all the money you spent in the vendor. Now it's pretty simple to get all the money back. As soon as you guys feel like you guys have enough and you're done with the selling and buying all that stuff, what you guys need to do is sell this painting. Now if you guys don't have this painting, I recommend watching my money guide before trying this out. And be sure to get back all the painting you sell to get all your money back. And that's pretty much it. So that's pretty much all you need to do, sell the painting to get the money back. But once you got your money back, what you guys need to do, be sure to get the painting back as well, because they don't cost much. So you could get buy it back, or you could, like, if you spend a lot of money, and you will be able to sell a lot of painting as well, and that way you could repeat the same process with this painting to get a lot of painting so you can make more money. And that's pretty much it. So be sure to get back the painting as well. And that's pretty much it for this video, fam. I hope you guys find it helpful, and if you did, leaving a like would really mean a lot, and I would really appreciate the support. And I'll be doing a ton more tips and guides related to Cyberpunk, so make sure you guys chip into this channel. And until next time, fam, stay awesome, stay safe, stay connected, and I'll catch you guys in the next one.